Hey guys, it's Destery. Firstly, I want to say I'm really sorry for not uploading a lot lately. I've just been really, really busy having sex with your mom! Oh! Your mom's a whore. I'm just joking. Your mom is probably a really nice, respectable lady. Except when I've got her in the bed. Oh! But yeah, I feel really bad that I, you know, keep walking in and out of your life like your father did when you were born. That's right, I'm dissing both of your parents today. But don't feel too bad. My dad did the same thing when I was born, except for he was nice enough to leave a note. And the note reads, "Sorry, son," and he spelt son S-U-N, so he didn't know how to spell, I guess. "Sorry, son, I have to GTG. Your mom is just a smelly whore." Oh, well, that's good. And then on the second page, he drew what appears to be a spaceship? I think that's, yeah, that's a spaceship. I don't know what he was doing, but thanks. I'm just kidding, I love my dad. And I'm sorry I dissed your parents, but I mean, they're not all that bad, because they created an angel. You. Ha ha! See how I turned that around? Oh yeah. That's why I'm the captain of a non-existent ship and you're not. Anyways, so my past couple of weeks, what am I doing with my hands? I do not know. So my past couple of weeks have been pretty crazy. So my past couple of weeks have been pretty... followed by, and then followed by, woo! So I guess I'll start off by saying that I saw my favorite music artist live. So I got to see the Postal Service live, and that was like one of the few experiences in my life where I had to like punch myself in the sack skin to make sure that I was like not dreaming. And sure enough, I was not dreaming, and my sack just really hurt after that, so that's good. I'll have a DesandNate video up soon about concerts, because I'm not usually a concert goer, so when I went to this thing, I was kind of just baffled by all the like retarded and mean people there that were just dicks for no reason. For no reason! Anyways, you'll hear more about that in that video. So that was awesome. After that though, I took a little road trippy thing to Virginia with a couple of people, and I think like the first day that I was actually out of the house, it made me realize how much of a dependent little pussy I've become. I was just thinking that if someone plopped me in the middle of the Hunger Games before it started, I would have been like, yeah, do you guys supply a toothbrush, or do we find that in the wilderness, or what? Also, just wondering, are there plug-ins in the wilderness? Because I might need to blow dry my hair. Yeah, I'd probably survive about 4 minutes. That's a window, just letting you know. But serious talk, my brethren. Like, the first day that I actually woke up, I was thinking, holy shit, someone actually woke me up. I've just been waking up whenever I fucking feel like it for so long that when someone was playing with my toes to wake me up, I thought World War III was happening. I should probably also mention that the best way to wake up is definitely having a cat play with your toes. I jumped out of bed like a fucking Kenyan. And right after that, I went to the bathroom and I realized that when you poop in someone else's toilet, two things happen. One, it just feels fucking weird. I guess I've just been so used to the comforting feel of my toilet caressing my butt cheeks that when I pooped in someone else's toilet, I was like, I don't like this. Their toilet was literally colder than Lindsay Lohan's heart, and the rim was tiny. It felt like Michonne from The Walking Dead's lips were cupping my butthole. And I say that because her lips are fucking huge. Like, her lips are so big that they have a zip code. But, I mean, they are no size for a toilet bowl, let's just say. And the second thing that happens when you poop in someone else's toilet is that you lose all level of badassery, period. It doesn't matter if you're James fucking Bond. You could be James Bond, and if you came in my house and you were like, "Hi there, my name is James Bond, and I have to take a massive shit." You no longer look at him like, "Oh man, you're a badass." Instead, you're like, "Ha, you pooped in my toilet, dude." But yeah, after that first day, and after pooping in someone else's toilet, I just tried not to be a bitch and not bitch about every little thing, and instead I just tried to whip my hair back and forth. Yeah, I don't even know what that means, but I did it. So yeah, the road trip pretty much ended in a place called Colonial Williamsburg. And that place was really cool because it's all like really old America. So like old buildings that you might see in like Revolutionary War times, and then there were like horses walking around and dudes that had the crazy wig things on, and it was just really cool to see like older type America.
Alright guys, really quick, which one of these three is the scariest? Got this guy, truly a player, and then we have him, this guy. He is just way too happy to be having that string. What are you doing, man? Oh, he's gonna hang someone. Oh, and then there's this guy who has fucking watermelons. And a Beetlejuice cap? He has a, oh, nice bandana, man. You know some fashion. This guy's styling for sure.
And I almost bought a pipe that looks exactly like Gandalf the Grey's pipe. I mean, I don't smoke anything, but if I did, it would definitely be from Gandalf the Grey's pipe. Or your mom's ass! Oh! So I got back from that trip about a week ago, and since then, my life has been pretty much consumed with Minecraft. I'm currently trying to build up a server right now, which is proving to be quite a bitch. Oh, and I just started watching Star Wars The Clone Wars, like, you know, the animated series thing. And actually, I really enjoy it. Like, I don't know if that's weird of me to, like cartoony animated things, but fuck it, because I just watched Land Before Time 2 like last week for like the 30th time. But one thing I did notice about Star Wars The Clone Wars is that Obi-Wan has to sound sexy at any given time. I was trying to watch it and see if there were any parts where Obi-Wan didn't sound like he was trying to seduce me, and honestly, there was none. I'm not even kidding, there'd be times when it was like, "Don't go in there, Anakin. It's a trap. Prepare for battle, Commander. Fire at will. We know you've raped almost a dozen villagers." It's like, come on, Obi-Wan, you don't need to sound sexy all the time. "And that's where you're wrong." I think, though, if I was a Jedi, I'd probably be from the planet Autotunica. Yeah, I'd come in handy because all the other Jedi would be, like, trying to interrogate this guy and use their mind tricks to control him, and they'd all be like, "You will tell us where the secret base's location is." "No, I won't. I will not give in. Ah."
"You will tell us where the secret base's location is."
"Okay, Obi-Wan, that was sexy, but no, I will not." And then I'd bust up in there and be like, "You will tell us the secret base's location." Oh. I will tell you where the secret location is, because that was awesome. I'm sorry, that was just a random side note. Oh, and I've been watching a lot more movies lately too. I went and saw World War Z, and I saw This Is the End. And I mean, they weren't like the greatest movies ever, but I seriously jizz whenever a new zombie movie is made, so haha. So that's been my last couple of weeks, and I'm gonna upload some stuff on DesandNate soon, so look forward to that. Make sure you're subscribed to that channel. And I'm also doing a video called Why I Like Ocarina of Time Better Than Majora's Mask. And before you start shitting your pants and saying, "Bah!" just go watch that video. I'll have it up soon on my gaming channel, so make sure you're subscribed there as well. Anyways, it was lovely, you know, talking to you and such, and if you want to keep the conversation going, here's my question for you today. What is the coolest road trip you've gone on? Because I haven't been on a lot of road trips, and a lot of them have been mandatory road trips, like going across, you know, country to go to VidCon and blah blah blah. What's the coolest road trip that you've gone on? I'm interested to know. So leave a video response or a comment below, and I will be checking all those out. And also, I'm going to be filming a Q&A next week, so if you don't watch that, I will stab you in your cornea. So you probably want to watch that. Anyways, I will talk to you next week, and I love you all. So fair winds. Woo!